Good morning, children. So today we are going to learn about thermodynamic properties. This is video number 3 from the topic of thermodynamics. Okay. So this is Lalita Peri, science teacher. Basically, I teach chemistry. Okay. And those who have not watched the previous videos, request all of you to kindly watch the videos to understand the concepts in a better way. Okay, so let us start with the topic of what? Thermodynamic properties. Okay, video number 3. Thermodynamic properties. Okay, so especially we'll learn about certain important properties. Okay, already we have learned certain physical quantities. Okay, so those physical quantities in terms of thermodynamics, we are going to categorize them into two types of thermodynamic properties. So thermodynamic properties are of two types. What are those? Two types of thermodynamic properties are there. Two types of properties. So what are the two types of thermodynamic properties? So first one is intensive properties. Intensive. And the second one is extensive properties. Intensive and extensive properties. So two types of thermodynamic properties are there. Okay. So intensive and extensive. So what are those? Okay, already whatever the physical quantities which we have learnt, that only we are categorizing in the form of intensive, extensive. Okay, so let us learn intensive properties. So first one are what? Intensive properties. Okay, the properties which does not depend on the quantity of matter present in a system. Okay, which does not depend on the quantity of matter. Okay, the properties which does not depend on quantity of matter present in the system. Quantity of matter is nothing but mass. Okay, present in the system. You call such properties as intensive properties. Okay, the properties which does not depend on what? Which does not depend on mass. You call such properties as intensive properties. Okay, so like for example, we'll learn certain examples. Okay, which physical quantities which we have learned in our lower classes comes under the category of intensive, and which physical quantities comes under the category of extensive? We are going to learn about that. So which physical quantities does not depend on mass, or does not depend on size of the sample, okay, or size of the system? Okay, let us learn some examples. Suppose if you take density, you can take the example of density. You can take the example of pressure. Okay, pressure. You can take temperature. Okay, refractive index. Okay, these all are the physical quantities exhibited by certain systems, isn't it or not? Okay, so density, pressure, temperature, refractive index, and surface tension, viscosity, okay, and melting and boiling points of substances. All these comes under the category of what? Intensive properties. Means what? They does not depend on the size of the sample. Okay, size of the system. Okay, they does not depend on quantity of matter present in the system. Okay, so let us learn, let us understand these properties. Okay, like density, I told you the example of density. Okay, density. Suppose density of water, you might have learned 4 grams per cc. Okay, if you take a glass of water or if you take a bucket of water. Okay, glass of water means quantity is less. Bucket of water means more quantity is there. But if you take a glass of water or if you take a bucket of water, okay, density of water remains same. It won't change. You are changing the quantity. You are increasing the quantity or you are taking less quantity. Doesn't, irrespective of the quantity, irrespective of the size of the sample, okay, density remains the same. Isn't it or not? Density of water, glass of water, 4 grams per cc. Even if it is a bucket of water, density of water is 4 grams per cc. So, irrespective of size, okay, irrespective of size, irrespective of size of the sample, irrespective of the size of the sample, okay, intensive properties will exist. Okay, irrespective of the size of the sample, the property remains the same. The property remains the same. Okay, throughout the system or throughout the sample. You can take pressure, air pressure. Okay, suppose if I stand in this corner of the room, air pressure is 76 centimeters of Hg. You have learned. If I go to that corner of the room, there also air pressure is 76 only. Isn't it or not? Please understand the concept carefully. Okay, so if I sit in a very small room, air pressure is same. If I go to a very big open area, if I go, or if I go to a very big room, there also air pressure is same. So air pressure, irrespective of the size of the room, it is same throughout. So it does not depend on the quantity of matter, air pressure. Even here temperature also. If I stand in this corner of the room, temperature is 25. If I go to another big room, temperature becomes 50. It will never happen like that, no. So temperature remains the same, okay, irrespective of what? Size of the sample. Okay, so temperature is a intensive property. And refractive index, you have learned refractive index, sine I by sine R. Okay, so it is generally in your lower classes you have learned that refractive index helps you to determine the brilliance of diamond. Okay, shining. Okay, so if you take a small diamond, refractive index is less. Big diamond, refractive index is more. No. Okay, so it is not like that. Does not depends on the size, even surface tension. Okay, surface phenomenon. Okay, and viscosity. Viscosity, sticky nature of suppose milk. Okay, small spoon of milk, same viscosity. If you take a glass of milk, then also viscosity never change with size of the sample. So all these physical quantities, density, pressure, temperature, refractive index, surface tension, viscosity, melting and boiling points. Okay, if you take small glass of water, melting point of water is 100. Big bucket of water, melting point won't change with size. Okay, so that's why this all comes under what? Intensive properties. So intensive properties does not depend on the quantity of matter, does not depend on size of the sample. Okay, and automatically extensive depends on size of the sample. Okay, so extensive properties are what? Extensive properties are the properties which depends on the size of the sample or which depends on the size of the system. Extensive ओके, एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टीज डिपेंड्स डिपेंड्स ऑन साइज ऑफ द सिस्टम, साइज ऑफ द सैंपल. ओके, डिपेंड्स ऑन साइज ऑफ द सैंपल. ओके, सपोज मास, एग्जाम्पल्स आर वॉट, मास. ओके, स्मॉल ऑब्जेक्ट इफ यू टेक इट विल बी ऑफ लेस मास, एंड बिग ऑब्जेक्ट इफ यू टेक इट विल बी हैवी, सो मास विल इंक्रीज विद द साइज ऑफ द सैंपल, इजंट इट और नॉट. इन द सेम वे वॉल्यूम, वॉल्यूम. ओके, वॉल्यूम एंड वर्क, वर्क एंड एनर्जी, ऑल एनर्जी टर्म्स यू कैन टेक एनर्जी. ओके, ऑल एनर्जी टर्म्स विल कम अक्रॉस. सो मास इंक्रीजेस विद द साइज ऑफ द सैंपल. वॉल्यूम, ओके, वॉल्यूम द मेजर ऑफ स्पेस ऑक्यूपाइड बाय ए बॉडी, यू कॉल इट एज व्हाट, वॉल्यूम. सो वॉल्यूम इंक्रीजेस डिपेंड्स ऑन द साइज ऑफ द सैंपल, इजंट इट और नॉट. इन द सेम वे वर्क डन, ओके, वर्क डन डिपेंड्स ऑन मास ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट. ओके, एंड देन एनर्जी टर्म्स यू हैव, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दिस इज, यू हैव लॉट मेनी एनर्जी टर्म्स यू विल कम अक्रॉस इन थर्मोडायनेमिक्स. ओके, इंटरनल एनर्जी, एक्सटर्नल एनर्जी. ओके, एंथैल्पी, गिब्स फ्री एनर्जी, हीट कैपेसिटी. ओके, एंट्रोपी, लाइक दैट यू हैव सर्टेन टर्म्स यू विल कम अक्रॉस. ओके, वी विल बी लर्निंग इन द नेक्स्ट कमिंग टॉपिक्स. वी हैव सर्टेन एनर्जी टर्म्स आर देर, दैट एनर्जी टर्म्स, ऑल द एनर्जी टर्म्स कम्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ व्हाट, एक्सटेंसिव. ओके, एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टीज. ओके, सो दे डिपेंड्स ऑन साइज ऑफ द सैंपल. एक्सटेंसिव प्रॉपर्टीज डिपेंड्स ऑन साइज ऑफ द सैंपल. ओके, सो एनर्जी टर्म्स, वॉट आर द एनर्जी टर्म्स, प्लीज रिमेंबर दीज वर्ड्स, विल बी लर्निंग अबाउट देम शॉर्टली इन द नेक्स्ट कमिंग टॉपिक्स, राइट. सो एनर्जी टर्म्स लाइक वॉट, इंटरनल एनर्जी, इंटरनल एनर्जी. ओके, एंथैल्पी, एंथैल्पी. ओके, व्हाट वी कॉल हीट कैपेसिटी, हीट कैपेसिटी. एंड व्हाट वी कॉल एंट्रोपी, एंट्रोपी. गिब्स फ्री एनर्जी, गिब्स फ्री एनर्जी. ऑल दीज आर व्हाट, एनर्जी टर्म्स. One or the other forms of energies, these all are. Okay, so all the energy terms comes under the category of what? Extensive properties. Okay, so here there is a small important note point you have to remember. How can we categorize? Suppose if they ask you like in multiple choice questions. Okay, how can we categorize? How can we immediately identify whether it depends on mass or not, or depends on the size or not? How can we identify? There is nothing much to think. But just remember in such a way that all the concentration terms comes under intensive properties and all the energy terms comes under extensive properties. Okay, now please remember like that. Okay, so make a note point. Note. Okay, a small note. Right? Note. All the concentration terms. I'll give you examples. Concentration terms means what? Molarity, molality, normality, mole fraction. Okay, the concentration terms which you might have learnt in solutions chapter. Okay, so all the concentration terms. Okay, all the concentration terms like what? Molarity, molarity. Okay, normality, normality. What we call molality, molality. Okay, mole fraction, mole fraction. Okay, all these concentration terms comes under the category of intensive. Okay, intensive. Okay, intensive. All these are what? Intensive properties. Okay, please remember that point. And all the, even it, you can take the example of pH also here. pH is defined as what? Negative logarithm of H plus ion concentration term, that is also. So pH, right? All comes under the category of what? Intensive properties. Now coming to extensive, all the energy terms, as just now I told you, all the energy terms comes under extensive. But a very important thing which you need to understand here. Okay, suppose if you take intensive properties, again as a second note you make, okay, the sum, the ratio and the product of all intensive properties is again intensive only. Okay, now sum, product and ratio. Okay, please remember, sum, product and ratio of any two intensive properties, is also intensive, okay, sum, product and ratio of all the intensive properties is also intensive property only. Okay, but if you speak about extensive, again a note point for extensive, sum of two extensive properties is extensive. Okay, now sum of two extensive properties, sum of two extensive properties is extensive. Okay, sum of two extensive properties is extensive, but product and ratio of two extensive properties is again intensive only. Okay, okay, now product and ratio of two extensive properties is again intensive. Okay, now product and ratio of two extensive properties is again intensive. Okay, so these points you have to remember. Okay, and one more note point also, a very important note point you have to remember. I told you that all the concentration terms comes under the category of what? Intensive properties. Okay, all the concentration terms, okay, comes under the category of what? Intensive properties. Okay, suppose if, and all the energy terms I said you comes under the category of extensive, all the energy terms. Okay, but if any energy term is taken per mole, okay, what I said, all the energy terms, if I write here you can see, right, all energy terms are extensive. I said this, all energy terms are extensive, internal energy, Gibbs free energy, entropy, enthalpy, all this. Okay, but if you take all energy terms per mole, then it will become intensive again. Okay, very, very important. Okay, energy terms per mole are what? Intensive. Energy terms per mole are again intensive. Please remember that point. That means what? Molar entropy. Okay, please remember like that. Molar enthalpy intensive. Okay, molar. If you use the word molar, molar entropy. Okay, entropy, enthalpy, we'll learn. But first, remember the names, remember the words. Okay, so molar entropy is what? Entropy per mole. Entropy per mole. Entropy per mole. Again, it becomes what? Intensive. Okay, again, it becomes intensive property. Because sum of two extensive properties is only extensive, but product and ratio of two extensive. Here entropy is extensive, mole is extensive. Extensive by extensive means it becomes intensive only, no? Entropy is extensive property. Okay, mole is also extensive property. Mole is also extensive property. So ratio of two extensive is what? Intensive, isn't it? So molar concentration terms, so molar entropy, molar enthalpy. Okay, molar enthalpy means enthalpy per mole. Okay, enthalpy per mole. Molar energy terms, again they become intensive only. Okay, so enthalpy per mole means this is also extensive, mole is also extensive. Extensive by extensive is again intensive, is again intensive. Okay, so energy terms all are extensive, but molar energy terms all comes under intensive. Okay, so just remember these all points and examples, then most of the questions will be coming within these examples only. Okay, not beyond this. Okay, so this is all about what? Extensive and intensive properties. Extensive properties depends on the size of the sample. Intensive properties does not depends on size of the sample. Okay, all energy terms comes under extensive properties, and all concentration terms comes under intensive properties. Suppose any energy term per mole, if it is taken, then again it will become intensive property only. Okay, so all these note points, if you are perfect with, then definitely it will become easy for you to identify which one is intensive and which one is extensive, right? So this is all about thermodynamic properties. Okay, so thanks for watching, dear children, and please make notes of what all your teacher says and then practice every day, right? Thanks for watching, and please remember, your hard work is your superpower, right? Bye.